Hello. We're back. The break was long, but we are finally back. Let me quickly get rid of everything we have here. Being perfectly honest, I don't remember anything. I have no idea. It's been so long. Most of these items probably are very bad right now. Do we have any buy orders? Actually, we do. Let me get rid of them. Yeah, 14 days ago. Oh my god. It's been a long time. I got really sick. I had to take a break. But right now we're back. Since it's December, I'm not sure how often this will be rolling out. I will try to stream every day, but yeah, the holidays are coming up. I can be busy. I don't want to make any promises or anything like that. One thing for sure, after holiday I will have much more free time, especially in January. So this should, like, this challenge should be finished in January. I'm pretty sure I will have enough time. What the hell is happening? So we basically wake up from coma when it comes to everything. You shouldn't be doing that on your own. So if you go away, just cancel your orders. We didn't do that, so. Well, it is what it is. 55, holy damn. I mean, we can check some things. I'm curious. Sales system. Oh, also, the flipping history is 849. We can. Wait, so the difference in profit is 100. Oh my god, that's a lot. 8. The silver. That's a lot. Yeah. 140. Okay, so we listed this correctly. Paid in fit. Oh, yeah, I cannot. Yep. Swim. That's plus 10 at 19. Oh. Talk to the guy. At 19. Okay, let's list here and hope it sells. What else can we do, really? Not much. Yeah. Basically, we are trying the best we can to take as little losses as possible. Since we were gone so long, for so long, I didn't really expect to be gone this long. But it is what it is. I'm not a streamer and I clearly cannot dedicate my whole life around it. Especially if I'm sick. Technically I could be uploading them like offline, but I really don't want to do that. the interaction part is, I believe that's nice to have. Oh. But science, I mentioned something that, wait, it shouldn't be this expensive, what? Right, give me a second. Lump. What the hell? Lump. We bought it for... Huh? We can insta-sell this. And I'm gonna do that. Because there is no difference between orders anyways. Yeah, things like this can happen basically. So we just made this, yeah, a lot of gold. It's free. It's free. But going back, science, I will have less and less time in upcoming week. We will swap a method for a moment to utilize the fact that I will be away. So we will drop this fast velocity for a moment and go to slow velocity, where I can just order many items and it will work better. Also regarding the guide, I was thinking about how I can improve the whole thing. So the challenge, understanding what's happening here, and overall more information for everyone. And the best conclusion I had would be, instead of writing whole guide where I struggle a lot, I could try recording individual videos about topics. This way I have more time to prepare every single topic, and also there will be more information in each video. At the end, maybe I would be able to do the whole guide based on the videos and so on, but I'll be honest, it's a hard guess. But I clearly noticed that these videos would be helpful because, yeah, it's obvious to me, but not obvious to new person who is watching this. What am I doing? Why am I doing it this way, not another way? You know, all these little details. I mean, sure, you can copy everything I do, but that's not the point. That's not why I'm recording this. Also, yeah, 37 hours. I'm pretty sure the stream is on day 17. This is not really true. I mean, it is true. This is my 17th day streaming, but this has been going for 8. Yeah, that's a long time now. This was the start, 8-11. I'm counting only days that I'm actually streaming. Because as you see, every time I'm streaming and every time the episode lands, this doesn't matter if you wait between the days or not. Like, flipping will still happen nonetheless. And as long as you follow the rules, the basic rules, you are good to go. So what the hell happened here? 6:14? Jesus. That doesn't look good. In the meantime, we have the Winter's Day event right now. This opened a bunch of items that could be flipped. Like, I don't know, the easiest example would be candy weapons. I think, you know, this. We can easily flip this for profit. And actually, I was thinking about flipping them on top of the regular stuff, because I know they will flip well. so why not? They're not losing anything. Why not? So yeah, on top of streaming, I would try slowly recording the topics I would want to mention regarding flipping. Probably starting with the basic, explaining the differences between the two general ideas, so slow velocity and fast velocity. So it's better to understand what I'm doing right here. I'm trying to do my best when I'm actually streaming, but yeah, it can go sideways. I don't always have time to explain everything I'm doing. So yeah, it can... I do believe this will help, that you can just click on the video and have the details more organized. 22, 27. I don't even remember at which prices we bought these items, so there is no way of telling if this is profit or not. Checking one by one is not an option, by the way. Nice, we are gonna list this. This is fragments. I'm pretty sure these are ours, but I'm not gonna risk. So we have 500 gold. We will be working with this today for the slow velocity list. So once again, slow velocity lists are very good if you don't have that much time. And you really want just to set by orders and wait. That's the general rule. It also helps if you want to go really slow, so like super low maintenance. In our case, this term will be used differently because I'm just not sure if I can stream every day. And that's the point here. So skipping days with slow velocity can be very good, basically. Yeah, I'm not sure about this one. Yeah, we bought them for TT. That's super bad. Let's list them here. And wait. And besides, I cannot stream every day, probably, because of the real life events. It will be better to just order, I don't know, 600 items, for example, and wait until they fill, instead of doing this. Because sure, I could be doing this. Wait, we again have this? Oh, it's different. Okay. This is 29, okay, that's cool. So yeah, sure, I could be doing this and just listing them every day, but the profit would be like super bad because we cannot really flip many items. Profit per item on this list is not very good, so you want to flip as many as possible, and doing this once a day won't be enough, so I'd rather swap to something that will basically allow me to buy one item and just be done with that item. Hello there. Yes, we are already at 500 gold profit. I mean, it's pretty slow still, for even for my standards. We could be much higher by now. This challenge have like a lot of limitations, so we're going pretty slow with profit margins. We cannot release, so whenever I click list the item, it's gone. There is nothing else I can do with it. so many final battles. And also we are doing this only 2 hours a day. Whenever I stream, that is. Yeah, that's kind of bad. So these two limitations are very bad. Is this all of them? No. How many do we have even? The heck? 28! Holy thing! Shit! Is this all of them? Yes, okay. Three more, okay. I guess. I'm doing these limitations only because there will be people that will argue that this is unrealistic, I cannot do it, I don't have this much time, or blah 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 something. So I'm basically proving them wrong in an advance. Oh yeah, this is Omega Loose, by the way. Oh shit. How much did we pay for this? Concentration? Yeah. Yeah, that is a huge loss. Nice. So what we will do is... Right. I bought them before Winter's Day, so... Okay, let's list them at 37. I don't know if they will sell, I'll be honest. It's weird. But I'm just hoping they will. Somewhere in the future, maybe in 1 year or something. We are not really starved on gold anymore. I mean, we are, but... It's much better than it used to be. Oh, I will say it like that. It's much better. We are still poor, but... It's just less poor. Okay? Just less poor. No duplicates? Really? Oh, there are. So I'm basically looking for duplicates. I remember I was ordering two of each for most items. So if I see duplicate, that means I won't have any more here. So I can list it and take this. And repeat. We have a limit how many items we can list, so we have to play around it. Nice. Stuff is selling already, that's super nice. For today, I will be checking one of the older lists. Yeah, we will be doing something like this. I'm not sure, let me just check. The difference is 50, yeah, more likely something like this. What about day 9? Day 9 is something like this. Okay. Yeah, this will be the baseline, I'm pretty sure. For today. It would be nice if you can... I do believe 600 items would be great. But I'm not sure if you can find that many. With the gold we have. It could be problematic. So we'll see how that goes. You can find this many items overall, it's just a matter of how much gold you have. And we don't have a lot. It will be gone in 1 hour. Okay, let's see. Okay, that's all of them. That's great. We don't have any buy orders anymore. So that's just listing everything. Okay. Can wait. Okay, let's see. We have a little of time, so okay. Let's go here. Let's see what we can create. What's maximum, let's say one gold, but I kinda... Okay, that's 600 items plus. Okay. Cost of this list is 18 gold. Okay, that's very good. What about this one? This one is 39. Okay. This was in 90. Okay. This is very interesting. Okay, we can get more greedy, I believe. Let's see. The 25 is a lot less, but it's still pretty cheap to buy all of this. Okay. We basically need to find the equilibrium in which we can spend 500 gold or more. Wait, where did I list the swords? Let me just check. Gate. 170. Why did I list this one? Huh? That's weird. Wait, did it list? What? Oh, I listed it by mistake. Okay, never mind. Ah, going back. We need to find the equilibrium where we spend all the gold and we order as many items as possible. Ideally for the best profit per item. So the more coins we get per item, the better. The ROI is not really that important anymore, because you cannot really buy an item for 50 silver and sell it for like 6 gold. Yet this doesn't exist, generally speaking. So ROI will be bad. You will probably pay for 50 silver, you would generally need to buy item between like 2 to 6 gold probably. So the ROI is like 20 something percent or something like that. But you can already see that if item costs 2 gold, then 200 items is 400 gold, so yeah. This is exactly why I said we are poor for this list, because we only have 500. So I need to find the middle ground. But first of all, we need to list items. That's the most important thing. Okay. So the ceiling here is way too low. Let's see. 37. Okay, that's great. That's 200 gold. Oof. So the tiered one probably will be... Oh, the tiered one doesn't exist. Okay. So that's still not enough items. So we can try... Yeah, how many will we get this way? If we do 20, so just 20? I really don't want to go lower. I really don't want to go lower. 25, okay. Then we have, that's 106. And here we have, yeah, that's 358. That still leaves us with leftover gold, so that's still not good. Okay. I could technically lower the profit expectation even more to like 15 silver per item. But that won't really help with the problem we have currently. I will do that, but yeah. I will do one more thing actually. Oh. 5 more gold. Don't mind if I do. Okay, so let's rise this to 3 fading. Okay, I want that. This is 18 gold to be expected. 58. 150. And this one. That's still 350. God damn it, that's still not a lot. And these items already cost 3 gold per one. God damn it. And the profit margin is also very nice. The only other thing I can think about is this one. Yeah. Okay. 18. What do we have here? 58. Okay. 58. That's 138. Here we have how much? 100. That's 368. And this list probably, yeah, that's perfect. Yeah. So we can do this. That's 8. Oh my god, that's 800 items. Holy damn. Do I really want to flip that? God damn it. That's a lot of items. We could technically go more greedy and just skip the safe items at the start. So the cheap ones. And why would you really skip them? Well, so you have less clicking. That's the only thing really. They're safe. So if we do this list, these 800 items, will combine both safety and a little bit of nice profit. But you could change it a little bit and just go greedy and skip the safety items. But I don't think we should do that. I mean, I can try and we can compare. So basically, if you copy this, it's the same settings because this page saves settings here. So You can even write the settings here and just, yeah, you get the idea. So how would we skip the cheap items? First, you need to increase this, and then you need to increase this to like 30, let's say. And you are slowly skipping, because this list already costs 60 silver here. And if we go to first page here, for comparison, so you understand what I mean. The first page ends at 40 silver, so there is a huge difference. This one is 60 silver already. So that's 55. That's 270, so that's 330. And this one is, yeah, that would be more gold that we have already. And we will finish with 400 items something. Yeah, this doesn't look bad either. The profit margins are very nice. We can even count the differences, let me see. 150. That's 400, and here we have 100. So, because we know that usually one third of the list sells, that would be expected profit from this list. What about this one? That's 52. Okay, let's open another one. It's 52 plus 57. So you can see these lists are very cheap, and then they don't yield a lot of raw profit, but they have huge percentage here, which means they are safe. Because if you sell item like this, you buy it here and you sell it here, you basically pay for another item with it, so it's safe. But in this case, like some of these items, for example here, it also pays for the item, but you are listing it 1 gold, the listing fee is higher. Or here, like sure, this pays for 5 items, but if it really sell, that's a question. But this is the 900 ROI. What is the lowest here? Yeah, 35. So you pay 170 here, you sell it and you get 1/3 of that. And we will have a bunch of items like this. Yeah. You will need to sell 2 of these to be able to order another. So this list is slowly going into more dangerous zones. Slowly but steady, of course. If you would do like lowest ROI 10%, that's super dangerous. We'll be doing that later on though, because that's how it is. For now, yeah, I kinda want to keep a little of safety. Oh, yeah. 72 in this case. Yeah. Let's see. Right now we are comparing the lists. What is better? But it seems they will be the same. Yeah, it's exactly the same. So the profit is literally the same, but you have 2 approaches to the problem. So I think we'll do this one and see how that goes. I'm curious. Let's load this. This would be the safer option, where you are asking minimum for this and 350, but in here we are going higher up, but we are asking for more raw profit. So basically the higher this goes, so buy order pay item, then you can ask for more profit when it comes to slow items. But if you lower this, you need to lower this, but you can increase ROI instead, so it can be like 50%. Because the difference won't be that big. At this point, it means more safety. It's very similar to the list we were doing the very first few days, when we were asking for like 100% ROI, so we are super safe. But right now, yeah, there is no room for safety anymore, basically. I wonder if we could, but no, not really. That's 470. Yeah, that's, I'm pretty sure that's enough. Yeah, I don't want to do more. Okay, let me quickly sell and send the this is day. Wait, I didn't say day 16. Or did I name the stream incorrectly? Let me see. Is the stream day 17? Oh wait, let me actually double check that. Did I make the typo in the stream title? It could be. I sure did. This is day 16, yes. I will quickly edit this. Yeah. Yeah, that's a mistake on my part. But it's nothing big, really. Okay, so we can get to it. The goal is to order each one of these. We can close this one. 11 gold, that's nice. Always happy to see the gold coins. Wait, can we take the items? I want to see the icons, so I'd rather take the items. sure, give me that, and give me that, I guess. And yeah, okay, now we can see this stuff. I will pick, wait, what is this, mini Flurry Dragon? I mean, sure, right, why not, yes. Let's have the dragon flying around. I don't mind. Nice! Stuff is selling very nicely actually. And let me check. This already sold, interesting. Yeah. There are a few things that I want to order out of Ordinary from Fast Velocity because I like them. I'm not sure why lamps exploded in price though. It's kinda weird. We can track it down actually. Because I'm curious. So you may ask why I open all of these tabs in advance. The reason is if you do that, you won't have duplicates. Because if you were to do this list and open the second one, it will update. And you may lose some items or gain new items, and then it can be a problem. Okay, what happened here? Yeah, around December it just exploded in price. I mean, the there was a new variant, but really that much? Interesting. Let's see if other things followed. Raid boosters, for example. Not really. Interesting. I mean, a little bit, yeah, but yeah, it's the variant. So variant decided on that. Memory will suffer the same, probably. I am pretty sure, yeah. So variant was released and up we go. This is basically common knowledge at this point. It's nothing fancy. Okay. We're selling like crazy. 6 days, 7 days. Yeah, account was offline for a long while. Like I said, I wouldn't log in without the stream, and that's still true. So we are keeping that promise. Oh, right. Okay. Ouch. I really hope we can wrap it up in January. I mean, we have been streaming for 16 days, yeah, 16 days. And we are closing in 1k profit already, so another, like, till the end of the month, we'll probably, like, we can order two. So another 14 days in this case, we'll probably hit. Yeah, that's a good question, how many will we hit? I mean, even counting like 200 gold per stream on average, which is low, that would be like 3k. Yeah, 3k something, yeah. I mean, yeah, I'm pretty sure we can end this in January. Wait, blue ones. It will be finished. And whenever someone wants to see how we are doing this, they can. They can check every single step we are doing here. It's all different. I mean, I trying to keep it different, but there are times in which we'll be repeating the same list all over again, simply because it's easier. Wait, what happened with the music? Ah, YouTube decided that we are not listening anymore. That's super kind. What? No, I clicked the wrong thing. That's my bad. I know that a lot of people are waiting for the 3,000-4,000 gold methods, and they are expecting some rocket science out of it. The truth is, that's not gonna be the case. We'll be doing exactly the same thing, just on bigger scale. That's about it. That's the only difference. So I don't really understand why there is confusion how to progress later on. It's the same stuff, you just need to scale it up. But I believe the problem lies with the understanding of what's happening here, really. So I'm pretty sure people don't understand the methods and how the scaling works. I can scale them no problem. But when you're starting out, the scaling probably can, yeah, be problematic. Wait, Lisa? Okay. You cannot really apply the same rules all over again and expect the same results. For slow velocity, you're always increasing... Wait, 61. You're always increasing the buy, so how much you're willing to pay per item. And if you're increasing that, you can ask for more profit per item. But the higher you go, you have to lower your ROI. And on top of it, you also have the velocity factor, which basically gives you even more room to balance out around your gold. Wait, I checked it 3 times and I forgot. Yeah, okay. But buy, profit, and ROI are the 3 major indicators there. And then you have velocity on top of it. Because if you take a look at the velocity here, some items have 6, 3, 6, 4. It's all over the place. So me setting 2-2 in velocity, it's just an indicator of the minimum I'm willing to take. That's about it. Everything else is really, to be decided, because site will show you all the better items, but not the worst ones. And that's the goal here. You don't want any worse items. So that's the bare minimum. When it comes to fast velocity, that's a little bit different. Because fast velocity items are really limited. And they change all the time. Which also doesn't help. You already saw a little bit in the past few days how easily you can spend the gold that you have, but the problem is with overdoing it. I mean, same apply to slow velocity, but the problem is you can easily mitigate in the problem of overbuying in slow velocity, where it's not really clear in fast velocity. Generally, when someone will tell you about it, they will give a percentage of how much you should craft daily or flip. So if item sells 20 times a day, they will say like, do 5% of that and call it a day. I mean, sure, that works, but you don't want to use silly ideas like that. Simply because you don't have time to calculate 5% of everything. Where 5% is just an example, it can be 20, it can be 15, whatever. So it's more about testing each individual item as you flip them. So whatever fast velocity you are doing, you can slowly increase the buy order if you see the item is selling well. Because like I said, they change a lot. So it's better to order like 15 of each at the beginning and see how high you can go by increasing it slowly but steady. And at one point you will reach equilibrium for each item. And you might ask, but I won't remember how many should I order? Trust me, you will. If you actually flip the item every day, you will remember. You will see the item and the number will pops up in your head like, yeah, this is 15, this is 25. It just works like that, so don't be afraid of doing that. I'm never writing anything down. That's a waste of time. I mean, you could do that. Like, you could flip in Excel, for example, where you write all the price points down and everything, your expected profit if you list here or there, whatever. The question is, do you really have time to do that? I personally don't believe you have enough time to do that. Maybe if you are investing, then it makes sense. So you basically remember after 3 months what the situation was. In here? No, not really. Going back a little bit to the just idea of scaling fast velocity. So, generally speaking, the faster items goes, the lower profit per item you will get. That's the general rule. Of course, there are some special items there and there that doesn't follow this rule, but that's rare. It's mostly new items or event items. For example, the candy weapons would fall into this category. Because the profit they are generating is not realistic. But since it's a festival item, it works like that. So, but if scaling goes with the rule of the faster it goes, the lower profit, this basically means that if you are asking for a faster item, you need to ask for lesser profit per item. ROI is kind of sketchy in fast velocity overall, because it can be 50%, it can be 3%, it's really weird. So you can skip the ROI, just make it so it's positive and not negative. But what this also means is that, let's say you create a list. Wait, we don't want to order that. No, I am not trusting. This is a bait. Let's say you're creating lists which have items that move between. Not between. Starting at 10,000 sold per day, right? And the profit margin on that will be like, I don't know, let's say silver to keep it math friendly. And you get 20 items out of this. So the list will show you that the cost of the list is like 2 gold and the profit is like 20 silver. And the ROI will be 10%, right? So you will think, oh my god, this is absolutely garbage. Why should I even do that? The key point here is if it sells and buys 10,000 times a day, you can probably flip it 2,000 times or something like that. This is just an example. And 2,000 times 20 silver, I mean, you can see yourself, that's 400 gold. So all of a sudden, the profit margin on this list is super good, like, oh my god. But the cost will also be super good, you know? So overall, you will need to flip items worth of 4,000 gold. And suddenly, the question of how can I scale the list, because I'm already hitting the cap of flipping. Oh my god, I don't know what to flip. I just showed you that there is no such cap. You can eat so much gold before you hit the cap. The cap starts around like 20,000 gold or something. If you have 4k, that's just beginning, you know. This is nothing. We are still a child in diapers. Later on, you are basically combining slow velocity with fast velocity, because you have so much gold and you can basically afford both of these lists at the same time. That is if you want to keep it daily, because if you don't want to keep it daily, then you can just go with slow velocity, because slow velocity scales up so high, it's insane. You can probably sink like 40,000 gold in slow velocity items before it even becomes investing. And investing can eat, you can only guess how much gold you can eat, but you can already imagine that's a lot. And yeah, we will reach that point and you will see that it's not much different from what we are doing right now, really. I'll be doing the same rules, applying the same settings, or at least similar. And I will also say that we don't have gold, even with 4,000 in my wallet, because we don't really have gold. And that's a fact. That's sadly a fact. You may wonder if I will ever say that we have gold. And the answer is probably no. Because there are always ways to eat the gold away, you know? Always. There is never enough gold if you are serious about like money making in this game. You could have 200k and I will still say that I'm poor. And wait, what's it? Yeah. It's true, I am poor. But right now, you can understand why I say that. In 5 minutes, I showed you how to eat 5,000 gold, or 4,000, in a silly example. And that's just a little part of the market. Just a little tiny bit of the whole trading post. There is so much more you can do. So no, all these numbers, they are nothing when we are talking whole game. And you want to talk whole game, because if you don't, then you are, at least in my books, flipping incorrectly. Because you still have the mindset of one regular player. And to be honest, that won't work. I tried it when I was starting out. I was flipping skins. And sure, it gave me some coins, but overall the profit was so slow and so bad, I would be better off farming in the game. The moment you start understanding the bigger picture... Wait, this is restoration, sorry for that. The bigger picture in this game, the more you will understand that, yeah, these numbers just don't mean anything. It's just a number, you know? And at one point, it was at least it was 4 million, yeah? I don't know, maybe people won't find it as nice as I did. But basically, I was flipping just for the sake of flipping. I didn't even need more gold at that point. I was just flipping because it was fun. I could explore the newer methods, the higher ones. The numbers would scale up. I would be having like thousands of gold daily in my delivery box, and also thousands of items to flip, you know. It was just so much fun to work with the market, see the flows. It wasn't really about gold anymore. Day by day, I'm proving that gold is just a side product of this fun activity that we are doing here. It just goes by. You receive the gold naturally. You know, just another day in Guild Wars, really. But just making some gold coins, and that's it. I still don't understand why people are buying energy clusters. So. There are better ways to get the title from this item. I guess they kind of want to waste gold. Quarter stuff. So much stuff is selling in the background also. I don't mind that because we need as much gold as possible. But yeah. Later on you can even flip infusions, actually. And I don't mean ghostly infusions for 50 gold. No, that's super bad. Flipping ghostly systems, oof. There is a reason why they are worth 50 gold right now, you know? So flipping them is not exactly the best idea. I mean, it will work to a degree, but... Do you really want to compete with all these people that are getting them from drops? From magnetic shards? Yeah, that's an unstable market. What I mean more is like, I don't know, Ember Infusion is like 800 gold. 800 gold that you can sink in one item, basically. Wait, that's Sundos, and we want this one now. Monsoon. Later on, I'm pretty sure you can even flip Chuck Infusions. Because buy order is like, I don't know what, 7000 gold? And you can risk it for 10,000 and you take 1,500 gold profit. Of course, you may say, but that's hard to buy. Yeah, I agree, but you would flip it when you have like, I don't know, 25,000 gold? Or even more? And at that point you just don't care. It's much better for you to click once for potential 1,500 profit, then click 200 times for the same amount, because that's more effort, and we need to value all the time. Like, there is nothing that comes for free. If you are not paying a price in coins, you are paying the price in time, and the time is not free. That's not how it works. I know that people would love to... Yeah, I was farming that item, so it's free. Yeah, that's not free. It never will be free. And sure, of course, some people will argue further that... Well, you could be having another job and just buying gems. I mean, sure, I could do that by... We are not really talking about spending real money, are we? The goal is to never spend real money. Not everyone can work another job just to buy silly gems in the video game. And some people probably do that daily. Oh, we can order like 5 of these actually. We are almost done with fierce 200 items. So that's nice. It should be quick. I don't expect today's stream to be like super long. I just wanted to let people know that I'm back, more than anything. So we can do that this as a test today, and tomorrow we'll check the results. Because as we already know, we won't buy every item on this list. We will only buy part of that. And from that part, we will only sell another part. So there is a lot of indicators on this side. The velocity is an indicator. The profit is an indicator, also the cost is an indicator, because you can always cancel the order, I mean the buy order. And since we are not flipping 20 items, we have to be sure that the thing we have created will not yield negative results. And I know that it can appear as hard and problematic, but I mean, do you really believe the things I'm creating here are hard and problematic? I'm trying to explain how they are working, what are you should be looking out for, all these tiny details. So do you really believe that it is hard? I mean, sure, I'm cheating a little bit because I know it from all sides, and you as a new flipper probably don't, but you can see how easy it is and how natural it appears to be. And second is, like, I'm not opening any of these items in details. I'm not doing that. That's a waste of time. You could do that. But why? Why would you waste time? One could argue that, but you're only flipping one quantity, so it doesn't matter. But what if you're ordering 5? Well, first of all, do you really want to order 5 of these items? That's the first question. And if the answer is somehow yes, then there is another question. How safe this item is? Because you should know how safe it is just by the list settings. I had one more argument, but I actually forgot. I'll be honest. Maybe it will come to me in a moment. Cherry picking is not really nice overall. Oh, I know, I just reminded myself. So if you would order like 5 of each from this list in particular at random, in order to know in my case at least, if the item is good or not, you would need to do this list for a few days. So probably, I don't know, 4 days of flipping exactly the same list. And going with this approach, you'll probably get the same item multiple times. And then after another few days, you can see if it sells, if it buys, if it flips, most importantly, because it could buy and sell but at negative profit, which, yeah, that's not a flip. You're just losing all. But you will be able to check the details of that in the flipping history. And since you can pick particular days from which you want the details on the website, you can pinpoint if these items are good or not. And you will be able to tell that. And later on, you can adjust the numbers on that list. So some item will be ordering more, so some will be ordering less. I clicked by mistake on the item. That's not very good. That is not very good. Can you go back? Yeah, thank you. Did we order this one? Okay. Like, there are ways to double check if what you're doing is the correct approach or not, but you have to think about it a little bit. It's not really rocket science. Trust me on that, this is not really a rocket science. This is nowhere close to being a rocket science. Or any science in that case. I'm literally brute forcing the TP. You can say that. Because I was exactly the same spot as a beginner. So I wouldn't know what's the best, right? Like, how can I know if this item is actually good or not, since the velocity numbers on this side are just indicator. So what I thought is, how can I brute force this? And yeah, the beginnings weren't perfect, right? You know, I was thinking to brute force 20 items, and you can imagine that. Yeah, that was a bad idea. That won't work. So why not try brute forcing 200 items and see how that goes? And well, it turned out it works. It just works. The more items you are doing, the more safety you are creating for yourself, regarding of which method at which point we are doing. It doesn't matter. The more unique items you are doing, the better. There is never a reason to do less items. From safety side, because if you want to maximize profit per time, that's a whole different story. But if you just want safety, then unique items are the king. So that was the breakthrough in my findings, that the more unique items you have, the better. And from that, I started to tinker with the settings in all ways possible to create all various things. And here we are. Just because I remember the rule of unique items, I can do all kinds of interesting things. It just works. It's that easy, you know? I know this axe. it's really interesting what you can do when it comes to TP. They announced like 2 days ago, I'm pretty sure, or maybe it was even yesterday, that they will be changing the TP for Chromium based instead of the current one. So most likely the how it's called, performance will improve. And if performance improves, that would be nice. That would be nice. I do wonder if they will change the TP in any way though. Because that's also an interesting one. Oh well, can't say, we'll have to wait. For now we have this. We are starting to order 1 gold per item. That's expensive. It's funny because we were starting with 2 gold. And right now we're flipping items that are worth 1 gold. Ah, we came so much to be in this spot. So many weird items. This is probably the very first time we ever touched these items. Because if you take a look at the older videos, you can always see that we were ordering cheap items. And we didn't really cross 1 gold mark ever, so this will be the first time, I'm pretty sure. Also, important thing to note is that you really need to think about future when you are flipping anything. And I don't mean buying and selling items, no, no, no. I mean, if you will have enough gold to do it the same tomorrow. That's the important bit. You really want to have enough gold to continue what you are doing tomorrow. And that can be, yeah, it can be problematic at times. And it will be mostly visible when you are doing way too little items. So today we'll be doing 400 something items. And I'm wondering if that's enough for this price point, you know? If this will work out, because we started with like 530 something gold, I'm pretty sure. And I wonder if tomorrow we will have around the same amount to continue at least the same thing. That's the question. Because we don't really want to go down, we want to go up, right? So stack items won't really help much. But this is also a reason why it's important to go through all the lower lists. Because not only you understand the methods in general better, but you also learn how to make gold at any given point. Which is important because I never said that we won't make mistakes in this challenge. There may be one day when I make a big mistake and we lose a bunch of gold, you know? So the question is if you can recover from that. You already know that I will be able to recover from it. Of course, it's not desired to do that because this will cost us additional days. But the idea is that you keep that at the back of your head, that you can recover, so it doesn't really matter if you lose gold or not, because you still know how to make it. Like, the profit didn't came from a lucky drop. You actually developed a skill that will help you out whenever you're stuck, at whatever point you are stuck. And if you are unsure about scaling up, you can always keep doing the same thing for like 2 weeks and just grind gold there, and then slowly move to another thing. This gives you a lot of room for improvement, because you are not really risking anything if you keep true to the idea of flipping. Because if you know how to go from 2 gold to 800 in profit, I am pretty sure you will be able to do it again, if that's necessary. And that only means that you are more willing to risk the 800 gold to earn more. Because if someone would be farming for like, I don't know, 2 weeks, 1 month, whatever, and they will farm that 800 gold, and they would decide to flip and lose it all, they will be angry that they don't know how to repeat the games. They will have to farm all over again because the flipping didn't work and it's so bad and all of these negative things. But if you go from the bottom slowly to the top, you won't have that problem. You will be that guy that is, okay, I just lose 2000 gold, meh, that's nothing, I can make it back. And that's the correct mindset to have. So that you understand the potential losses. Because profit comes with losses. It's a full package, you cannot skip it. Like, every item that is stuck currently on the TP is a lose for me. And it's double the loss because I cannot even touch it. I cannot release it. So it's even more problems in my case. In your case, you can always release it and try to unlock the stuck gold. So you can flip something that you already flipped in the past and you know it will flip. In my case, I don't have that much. So safety in my case would be the top priority. We are not going at the fastest pace, but we are going at the steady pace. And if anything, I want you to be in the same boat. You don't have to go at full speed. It's better to learn how to go slow but steady instead of going fast but once. It kind of sounds like a car crash related thing, you know, but yeah. It is similar, because you can crash at one point in here and just lose all the gold. Many people came to me and said that they tried flipping and they lost dough. And they started with 500 gold, 5000 gold, all kind of numbers. And this challenge is exactly for that. So that people can experience the whole journey. And they can see that even if potential struggles came up, like for example me being away for 2 weeks, basically, they won't stop the profit we are making. They won't change anything. We'll still go forward every single day. And right now, with the 500 gold in our wallet, just that, we already have 250 times more gold than we started with. That's a lot. That is simply a lot. And like promised, we didn't move one bit from Divinity's Reach, aside from sometimes when I'm clicking the thing in the game. But that's a mistake, okay? That's not intended. I just misclick sometimes. Flipping shouldn't be scary, really. It's never meant to be scary. Oh, thank you. Yes. Finally, I am feeling better. Feels nice. But the amount of medication I had to took is just... I mean, I'm still doing some meds, but it's much, much better. So I'm positive it won't come back to me like the last time. But yeah. Meds are not really nice. What the hell is... No, this guy is trolling. What the... Okay, this is this one time I'm gonna check this guy, because this guy is hella trolling. Why would he do that? Oh my god. I don't want to use gamer words, but this guy is just... So the price was at 1 gold, and this guy just decided to randomly increase, and other people are following it for 5 days now. Yeah. I wish I could report people on based on their listing in Trading Post. I really wish that would be the case. Some people are just monsters. 1 copper more, that's the rule, 1 copper more. And if you don't want to do 1 copper more, just insta-buy it. Trust me, if someone wants to insta-sell an item on the Trading Post, they generally don't look at the price, okay? They don't care, they just want to get their item done. So there is no reason to just increase it by like... It's just silly. Just silly thing to do. Don't be silly. Please. Also, let me flip in peace. I'm surprised there is so many Marauder items. I don't even know if this is a meta build or something. Probably is, but... Let's buy Precision Vitality Ferocity. Yeah, I highly doubt that's the meta. Why would you need HP for anything? What's the point? Are you a casual one? That's why you need HP. I mean, probably casuals are buying this set because of the vitality, yeah? They want that sweet HP go up and be more tanky, I guess. Sinister pal. Right, we are here. That's good. We have 15 items to pick up. I will finish the list and we'll list them. Wait, where are we? Here. So... Wait, this is the music box. Wow, it's so cheap these days. Oh my god. These music boxes are very special. Like, this was a really interesting attempt from ArenaNet to introduce rare items, because you can drop them from Puff of Fire. I don't even know from what exactly. It's probably related to some kind of content or something. I don't know. But they are hella rare. Like, getting one is absolutely bonkers. It's like precursor drop. The fact that they are so cheap is because of the niche use for them. So it's really a fun product to have, but nothing else. It gives nothing interesting. So in the past, these boxes were... Wait, let me just... Okay. Like, we can check. You see, like, it's... Oh, come on, load it. Thank you. Okay, let's just... Yeah, this is January. Like, the first one was listed for 10k. It's probably still listed. Yeah, it's still listed. It's funny. And then it slowly dropped, of course. It was for 900, 600, and slowly but steady, it reached 200. This is, yeah, this is May and this is June. So we can see the price drop already. And if we increase it a little bit, through the June to July, and we already hit 50 gold. And right now, as you can see, it's 4 gold. This is because even if this item is rare, it doesn't really have much uses. Now, this flashbang is just oof. It's a music box. And music boxes just give you music. And that's really, it's a funny thing to have, but it's nothing mandatory, and a lot of players are not really unlocking it. Instead, they are listing it. But as you can see, the same applies the other way. Not a lot of people are buying them, so... Yeah, it's a niche product that is just rare. But rarity alone doesn't give the sense of price in any way. It can, but that's not the rule. Because if a casual player is not buying this item, then it's not gonna be expensive. That's basically the idea. So it was interesting item from them to add a rare item, but they failed it because it's just a music box. If this would be a skin, and I can also give an example of such skin, because we still have time. I'm pretty sure it's called like... I don't even remember how it's called, so let me just... yeah, armor, exotic, yeah. It would be easy to find this. And if you go by price, you can see the invisible, but that's another story. And you can see Cavalier set, which is absolutely expensive for no reason. Like, what the hell is happening here? And this is exactly the same case. It's just super rare. It comes from 3 containers and it's super rare. But why this item is so expensive still? Because this is, first of all, a skin and exotic. So some may think that this is a better exotic. We know that's not true, but then they may buy it for skin because they think this is the only way to get the skin. And you can see this stands true because people actually buy them. The thing is, if you were to actually research a little bit, you know that this is not the only way to get this skin. Because you can also get it from Warbeast Westmount. And you can craft it. And this crafting is like 20 gold, maybe even less, depending on the... That's 4 gold. Let's see. That's 3 gold if you were to insta buy it, that is. Yeah, that's 10 gold. But people are not aware of this. Like, casual player doesn't know, he doesn't check. So he buys it. He just buys it. And you can see times and times it was 600, 300, 200. It goes down because with time, more and more people have it unlocked. So it's natural that it will go down. But you can see the supply is around 20 at all times, sometimes even lower. Simply because it's so rare to actually get this as a drop. So comparing this to a music box, you can see which one turned out better. The music box is just silly, while this is pretty interesting item. And I'm pretty sure you can flip this, by the way, but yeah, it's gonna be hard to flip this if you want to attempt at this. You can, sure, but yeah, that's gonna be a weird ride. Not sure if you want to try that. You can, but I'm not taking that risk. I don't have that money. No. It's just a little bit of trivia. I love the music boxes simply because of the idea they were introduced to the game. Sadly, yeah, that's just a music box. And why would you care about a silly music box? I mean, some people did care, like the guys that want everything unlocked, or they just love music in the game, whatever it might be. And they bought it for like 100 gold, 200 gold in the past, and now it's 5 gold. Sure, they did, but it's such a niche that, yeah, it won't work in the long run. When it comes to the armor, it does work because it's skin. And people love skins in this game, that's a fact. So, yeah, a little bit of a difference there. What the hell is happening here? Why is people griefing so much? Oh my god. Oh yeah. So why did that? What? Yeah, this is a case of overbuying, by the way. What the hell? Oh shit. Some people don't know limits, you know? They just... This is just insane. Okay, let's waste the remaining gold we have. I wonder if this will be enough. Because I can still see 200 gold in my pocket. This is 3 gold per item. Yeah, that hurts. But you can see, I'm casually ordering them. I don't care. Just casual flipping. Quarter star. Also, I can see a rare visitor on the stream. It's Illy. I didn't even know you were following me. That's kind of weird. How do you know about this stream? It's meant to be hidden. Berserker 70. I wish they would introduce more items like this in general. Like random drops, or I don't know, hardcore achievements. But you can sell them on the TP, that's the thing. People like things like this. Even if they are complaining that it's too expensive or something. People like having expensive things, that's a fact. I'm pretty sure that majority of you, including me, bought an expensive exotic when they were starting out simply because they thought it was better than the other one. And I don't even mean like statistic sets, but rather the amount of statistic it would give you. So we would combine. It's expensive, so it has to be better, right? Yeah, the problem is it's not. This game doesn't work like that. It's not. It's level 80, that's the best you can get. Like, there is no difference if the exotic costs 50 silver or 15 gold. But people will do a lot of things for a skin. Funny enough, I know about the armor pieces. Because I really liked the mask from Light Set. Because it's like a visor thingy, I don't know how to explain it. But I was wondering if I can get it cheaper instead of paying like 200 gold for it, because that's, yeah, that's a little bit too much for a headpiece. So I'm like, okay, let me see if I can craft it or get it from somewhere. And I'm like, wait, you can get it from this set and you just craft it for like 20 gold back then? And I was like, this can be real, so why are these so expensive? And I went and checked, like, they are just rare drops that people are constantly buying because they are unaware that you can craft the other thing. And that's it. That's the story. About the music boxes, I know because I was thinking about investing in them when the first one ever dropped. But I quickly understood that it won't work because it's a music box, so idea was quickly ditched, you know. 62. What is 62? Hello. 62. Yes. Oh, we are actually running out of gold. And I was wondering if you can do that. Yes. That's nice. I want to go to zero coins, if possible. Like, a lot of why flipping works in general is because people don't understand better. They didn't research the topic in detail, they don't know, like, item qualities, why this item is expensive in the first place, all these tiny details. And it's okay that they don't, because this is a video game. Like, you don't want to bother to check every single thing, right? You don't have to be a wiki expert in order to play the game. It's all fun because this is a game. And it's important to remember it so that you are not hyper toxic towards these people. Like, we all have different goals when it comes to games, so there is no reason to be angry because someone is doing differently than you. And we don't have gold, by the way. We have 5 gold. Okay. Let me quickly run. Let's see how much profit we made in the meantime when I was doing that. The stream is live for 1 hour and 40 minutes right now, so yeah, there's something probably sold. Let's see how many actually. Well, let's see. I hope we can hit like 1k profit tomorrow. That would be sweet. Oh, nice. It's always nice to see these things. Okay, that's additional 23 gold? 24 gold, yeah. That's nice. Yeah, we probably can hit 1k by tomorrow, I'm pretty sure. I am pretty sure. I'm surprised this actually flipped. 8 silver and sold on one thing. And it's... Holy damn. What happened here? We bought it for 8 silver and it's 8 gold right now. Oh my god. Where did we bought it for? I'm curious now. This is 2 gold. Oh, here. Wait. Interesting. Someone bought them up again. Yeah, that's super interesting. We could be selling them for 8 gold right now. Of course, I wouldn't know that. Like, I'm not watching items in particular. But it's interesting that someone is trying to manipulate this market a little bit. And since the supply of this one is really limited, yeah, it can work. It's only sold by this merchant. Because this is, yeah, this is achievement, so yeah. And this merchant have it randomly, so basically whenever this merchant have it, let's go month. Whenever this merchant have it, people will buy it and insta sell it like crazy, like here, you know, just boom, supply 150. And then someone bought it up again, and here we are. I could technically go to my main account and buy it further, but since someone bought how many? Yeah, he bought... I'm not sure, but he probably bought like 100. It would be risky to do so. Because supply is 35, so he probably have a lot of this stashed up. It will be risky, so it's much better to buy order it and sell it on sell order. We can actually do it, I think. No, okay. Just for the sake of seeing how it goes, we can... Let's see some... Yeah, this looks bad. Okay, let's dish this. And let's go here. We don't want to pay. I mean, if we list it for 20 gold. Yeah, I guess. Let's try. And we'll list it for 20 gold. Maybe it will sell. Who knows? Who knows? And for now, I just want to do this. One out bidding and we are finishing the stream. I'm pretty sure I can stream tomorrow, so yeah. We will see. I will see you tomorrow. There won't be a big gap again. Next week, I'm not sure, especially around Tuesday, because I have important appointment, so I'm not sure how that will go. At the end of the week, around Friday, again, I will be gone for a few days. Because of the holidays. But after holidays I'm back. And yeah, I don't have anything else after holidays. So we can continue doing this for a long time. Which one is the one go on? Catsic, Clickerino, the pants. Okay. The sword. In this case, we are outbidding literally everything because we are also ordering one item. So even if someone outbids us with one item, that's a threat to us and we have to outbid it. So we are not skipping the ones. In fast velocity, ones doesn't matter because they will quickly buy. So you can skip them, but in here, you have to outbid everything. The only thing you wouldn't outbid really is if someone is silly and going with the order way too high. That's the only... the only scenario in which you wouldn't really outbid. But all other you just outbid. Okay. Berserk. We are actually outbidded on many items, I'm surprised. Then again, it's not all of them. Oh, in here someone is silly. Yeah. We are not following that. I'd rather wait. Really, I'd rather wait. And since we can wait, I will wait. Oh right, I didn't click the thing, I forgot. Okay, this is already 27. We are already at cheap items, so it will be quick outbidding really. Ideally, you would want to outbid this every 2-3 hours. So, in a period of time of, like, let's say, 1 day, instead of buying one tier of items like I am doing, you would buy every single item. I mean, even outbidding twice would be a great deal. Any further outbidding like that will give you more coins. The snowy dragon is going. Okay. We bought a few more items, I noticed. Showing. We are ordering 5 of this item because I remember this from Fast Velocity. So I know it sells better than these items. That's exactly the reason. Actually, let's order more of this. Not because of the profit margin, but because I know this item. Like, being able to recognize items is important skill. And yeah, you will also get it if you continue flipping. Of course, there are times that you will miss information about a particular item, but just like I did with the recipe. Then again, it's a lot of items and unique connections between them, all this stuff, so it can be, you know, overwhelming if you think about all of them at all times. But there is a lot of connections, interesting trivia. And I don't know all of it. I started playing with Head of Thorns myself, so I don't know anything before that time period. You could probably read it up or ask someone who was playing around that time, but that's not the same. Oh, someone is silly. We are not following that. Wow. A bunch of competitors. Someone is probably following earlier videos because we are outbidded on everything. I wouldn't be surprised really. But it's nice to have flippers around. People generally say that they are market manipulators, but do you really see me manipulating anything? I'm simply offering my coins if someone is willing to sell, and then I'm simply listing the item for someone to buy it. No manipulation. People that are trying to manipulate for most part are pretty stupid. Because most manipulation doesn't work. It simply does not. Okay, 5 items to list and we are good to go. Sanctum of Dreams, the weapon. Okay, we have 7 gold. That's it. I'm not gonna outbid anything else. We can last one time. Change the profit. 874. That's it. Wait, why? That's it. Today we played for 2 hours. Yeah, almost 2 hours. Yeah. So another chill day with chill gameplay, and that's it. That's the whole thing. We have 8 gold left. Technically, I could buy some items, but I don't really care that much. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, see you guys tomorrow.